Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I am upgrading my 3D printer's build surface. If you all have seen my previous videos, you might have noticed that many of my prints had trouble sticking, especially in the front left corner of the bed. Although the glass build plate was flat, over time it developed a lot of scratches, which caused wear and tear on the surface, making it difficult for prints to adhere properly. I also had to slow down the first layer speed to 30 mm/s in the front left corner just to give it enough time to stick, while the rest of the bed printed fine at 60 mm/s. So it's time for a change. I'm switching to a magnetic textured flex plate, and I'm excited to show you how it improves adhesion and consistency. Let's dive in. So what I gained by making this switch? Magnetic textured flex plate. I replaced the old glass surface with a magnetic textured flex plate. This new surface not only provides better adhesion, but also makes removing prints much easier, thanks to its flexible nature. Plus, no more worrying about scratches affecting print quality. Consistent first layer speed. Now I can print with a consistent first layer speed across the entire bed, including that tricky front left corner. I no longer need to slow down at 30 mm/s in certain areas, which saves time and results in more reliable print from the start. This is the old glass bed. If you see, there are a lot of scratches over here. All these are scratches. And I had a difficulty in getting prints stick well in this front left corner. And this is one of the test print where you can see this particular area. It never sticks well. And a more closer look to the test print. This is the new print bed, 220 volts and 500 watts. It will be around 2.5 amps. The PEI flexible plate, the top surface of the bed, and these round ones, these are the magnets. Two things I would like to highlight here regarding this bed. The first, the bed heater pad isn't covering the entire aluminium bed, and the second, the temperature on top of the build plate is off by 10 degrees compared to the stock bed with a glass on top, which is off by 4 degrees. We will require some extra wires and a solid state relay to handle the AC load of 2.5 amps. This wire will be used to connect from the printer mainboard to the solid state relay. On one side, I have terminated with spade connectors, and on the other side with ferrules connector. This cable will connect from mains AC live voltage to solid state relay terminal on the load side. The ends of this cable are terminated with spade connectors. And this is how the solid state relay will be connected. These two wires are from the bed heater pad. This one is connected to the solid state relay, and the other one, that is this one, will terminate to the mains AC neutral terminal. This wire is connected to the mains AC live terminal. These two wires are from the printer's mainboard heater bed output. The positive wire is terminated to the positive terminal, and the negative wire is terminated to the negative terminal of the solid state relay. Now let's do the installation. Before we start, turn off the printer and disconnect the AC power cable. Please note, if you are not comfortable, kindly get help from an electrician. These two wires are coming from the printer's main board where you connect the heater bed. This is the positive terminal and the negative terminal. The bed heater pad output wires are this white one. One will go directly to the neutral terminal of your mains, and the second one will go to the solid state relay, the second terminal. So this is the first terminal, the second terminal, third and fourth. This wire is your AC mains, which is connected here. So it connects from here like this, and it is terminated over here. So this will be your mains AC live input. This will be your output once the relay is turned on, which is connected to the bed heater pad. I'm using the Victritech Manta M5P board, and we need to change only the TBH, that is thermistor, bed heater, and HB, that is heater bed. These two ports, we need to change the cable. And this is how the solid state relay is connected to the main board. These two wires, they are coming from the solid state relay. So this is the positive terminal and this is the negative terminal. Now let's see the bed heater pad thermistor connection. You'll have to terminate with this terminal and install it into a housing like this. I think this is a GST 2.5 pitch spacing. And this is where I have connected the bed heater pad thermistor. If you will use this bed on your Ender 3, you will need new screws for this bed with a size of M4 by 40 mm. As the stock screws for my printer, they are of M4 by 35 mm. They work but are slightly shorter. Locally, I had access to these 60 mm screws, so I will have to cut them down to the correct length. Now that the hardware installation is done, we'll proceed with the configuration. Since we have changed the bed, we only need to change the sensor type, which is this one. With this bed, as per the supplier, they have asked me to set the sensor type as generic 3950. After that, go ahead and save and restart the printer. Once the installation and configuration is done, connect back the AC power and power on the printer and hope nothing goes bang. If all okay, check the clipper screen or the mainsail dashboard if the temperature for the heater bed is reported correctly. Once restart is done, we need to start with the PID calibration test. For that, we need to first copy this name. We need this name because we'll be doing the PID test for the bed and this name is required. So we'll go back to the dashboard, then console over here. And we'll run this test. So make sure that this name heater_bed is set to the correct one as defined in the printer.cfg file. Go ahead and click the play button. Now this will take some time. Once it is done, it will throw out some message over here asking you to save, or you from the clipper screen also it will prompt you to save and restart. Once calibration is done, you will get this message like this. And from here, we have to copy this command and paste it over here and then click on the play button. Now that everything is okay, proceed with bed knob adjustment and Z calibration. And once that is done, proceed with some print tests. And now some test print. Here is a comparison of a test print with old glass bed versus new magnetic flex plate. Thank you so much for watching. I would love to hear your thoughts, so feel free to drop a comment below. Don't forget to like and share if you found this video helpful. Until next time, I'm Remy and I'll see you in the next video. God bless and stay safe.